So Apar is saying that after reading Rumi, a fear is rising. What if the way too is tiring then? But when did Rumi assure you that the way is not tiring? In fact, all that Rumi is saying is you are already tired. That much is known. You are prone, susceptible, vulnerable to tiredness. It is well known. And somebody who is already tired is being invited to walk away. For sure, he will get only more tiredness. So, there is no uncertainty. You are asking, what if the way too is tiring? There is no doubt. Why are you feeling 50-50? It is 100% certain that only more tiredness is going to be there. Only more tiredness. Rumi is honest. He won't hide these things. He is saying it is tiring, obviously. But something more important than your weariness, your fatigue, something more compelling than your tiredness, would pull you. That thing has come in the shape of Rumi for now. And that's the whole beauty of it. Not tired, anybody would like to have a stroll. It is pleasuresome. I am not tired and just have had dinner. Let's go for a night walk. There is nothing in that walk. But it becomes special when you are tired and you have no reason to walk and yet you find yourself running. And you are not deceiving yourself. You are not hiding it from yourself that you are tired. Yes, obviously I am tired. But there is something much more important than this. I have to run. What is more important than this? Well, if there were a reason to walk, there could be a bigger reason to not to walk. Every reason can be defeated by a bigger reason. Because reason always has its limits and boundaries. So, whatever is done for a reason can never be immense. It would always be petty. One reason would compel you to do something, another reason would come in your way and tell you to not to do it. So, what is the reason to walk? There is no reason, just madness. And Rumi is mad, always drunk. He has no taste for water at all. He says, either give me wine or give me nothing. Leave me alone. Only such a madman can walk without reason. So rest assured, there is a lot of tiredness. The question is not at all about tiredness. The question is, do you know something bigger than tiredness? Tiredness is assured, guaranteed. So relax your heart. There is no need for your mind to be uncertain about the question of tiredness. Tell your mind to relax. Tell it, tiredness is certain. Then come to the bigger question. Do I only know the mind? Do I only know tiredness? Or do I know something of the heart? Do I know something beyond tiredness? Remember, beyond tiredness does not mean not tired. Beyond tired does not mean not tired. Beyond tired means tired yet not tired. You will have to appreciate the subtle difference. If you are not tired, then you can get tired. These are dualistic stages. The one who is not tired in the morning will be tired by the night. But the one who is not tired, even when tired, will never be tired. Not tired when not tired, and not tired when tired. And this not tired, remember, is not the same as the not tiredness that you feel in the morning. It is not physical, not mental. When I am saying not tired or beyond tired, when I am saying not tired, I mean beyond tiredness. So this is not the relaxation that you experience when you wake up after 8 hours sleep. I am not talking of that relaxation. I am talking of something within your heart that refuses to not to walk towards your love even when you are deeply tired. You are deeply tired. In fact, your body may be shredded. You may have been reduced to a mass of wounds, and yet you are walking. Yet you are walking. That is what is beyond tiredness. Kabir says, "Zarra zarra ho rahe tabhu na chhade khet." So you have been really shredded down, zarra zarra. You hardly are in one piece physically, and yet you refuse to give up. You cannot give up. You are that. How will you give yourself up? Something so dear, something so intrinsic, that it is improbable, impossible, undoable that it can be dissociated from you. That is the question. Do you know something of that? Is there something in your life, anything in your life that is so precious that you cannot separate from it, come what may? If yes, then this is the way. If no, then go and sleep. You are tired. Hmm?